Nick, just a couple of days ago, the hockey world was pretty shocked after a certain winger went ahead and signed a one-year deal with a team that nobody really expected. And I'm talking about Jimmy Vesey signing with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Nick,
No.
We're going to get into Taylor Hall, but this team has truly revamped their roster in the last week or two, and leading back to some of their offseason signings, but before that. But what are the vibes around Toronto right now? And what can we expect from them going forward? It doesn't seem like they're done yet.
I think people are always cautiously optimistic. The talk of the town, as you guys talked about earlier, is Joe Thornton. What is he, 700 years old now? Like, it makes no sense. They have Joe Thornton. His name is Jason Spezza. I think year in and year out, you're going to continue to see this. As long as Kyle Dubas will not trade one of the big four, their bottom six, they're going to have to go cheap with sort of guys that you bargain with and try to get a good price on. Wayne Simmons wants to come home. You know, I felt like asking, was it 2017 or 2020 that Jimmy Vesey, last time around, spurned the Maple Leafs, didn't sign here, goes to Buffalo. We all know how that worked out. And now he's back. And he'll be contesting for a bottom six role. I think, you know, very similar to last year where guys like Pontus Aberg were in the fray. You know, Matt Reed. I mean, those type of guys are going to be vying for these opportunities. You know, to answer the hoopla about Joe Thornton, I just don't think it makes sense, especially from this standpoint, the way this league is going speed-wise. You know, imagine list your player. Imagine Connor McDavid coming into Scotiabank Arena, crowd or not, and seeing Spezza and Thornton hop over the boards. He'd have a field day, not to mention he already has a field day with the Maple Leafs. So I don't think the Thornton thing is going to work. I think all in all, the Maple Leafs have to feel good. I know the fan base here and everybody around is feeling cautiously optimistic is the way I would phrase it. I like the TJ Brody addition. Maybe they spent a bit more than they'd have to, but again, you're going to have to pay up if you want to get that defenseman. I like that piece of business, the veteran qualities, you know, the physical nature that a Wayne Simmons and a Zach Bogosian bring in, I'm on board with. So all in all, it's very intriguing to live in this market and the GM not get bashed. But that's pretty much what we're seeing over the last week. A lot of people seem to be very content and happy with what's going on here.